Said that anything can happen here in the World Wrestling Federation, but now more than ever, truer words have never been spoken. This is a conscious effort on our part to open the creative envelope, so to speak, in order to entertain you in a more contemporary manner. Even though we call ourselves sports entertainment because of the athleticism involved, the key word in that phrase is entertainment. The WWF extends far beyond the strict confines of sports presentation into the wide open environment of broad-based entertainment. We borrow from such program niches like soap operas, like The Days of Our Lives, or music videos such as those on MTV, daytime talk shows like Jerry Springer and others, cartoons like The King of the Hill on Fox, sitcoms like Seinfeld, and other widely accepted forms of television entertainment. We in the WWF think that you, the audience, are quite frankly tired of having your intelligence insulted. We also think that you're tired of the same old simplistic theory of good guys versus bad guys. Surely the era of the superhero who urges you to say your prayers and take your vitamins is definitely passé. Therefore, we've embarked upon a far more innovative and contemporary creative campaign that is far more invigorating and extemporaneous than ever before. However, due to the live nature of Raw and the war zone, we encourage some degree of parental discretion as it relates to the younger audience allowed to stay up late. Other WWF programs on USA, such as Saturday Morning Live Wire and Sunday Morning Superstars, where there's a 40% increase in the younger audience, obviously, however, need no such discretion. We are responsible television producers who work hard to bring you this outrageous, wacky, wonderful world known as the WWF. Through some 50 years, the World Wrestling Federation has been an entertainment mainstay here in North America and all over the world. One of the reasons for that longevity is as the times have changed, so have we. I'm happy to say that this new vibrant creative direction has resulted in a huge increase in television viewership, for which we thank USA Network and TSN for allowing us to have the creative freedom, but most especially, we would like to thank you for watching. Raw and the War Zone are definitely the cure for the common show. Common show. Entertainment mainstay for creative freedom, the outrageous, wacky, wonderful world known as the WWF. WWF.
Hello.
Hello, everybody. We're actually here this week. We did it.
Yeah.
No problem. Well, the NXT thing happened, but I don't know how the show went because I was preparing for this. So, yeah. Vince McMahon Beastie Boys mashup. Good way to start something off, I feel. That was it's called the Gratitude Era. It's on SoundCloud. Pilkingtronics made that, Carl Pilkington. So just kidding.
Neat.
Yeah, it's on there. So find the whole thing, it's on there. It has a bunch of Ad Terra mashups of fucking like Stone Cold and Jeff Jarrett. But those guys are too good for this.
I would rather not even acknowledge Tiger Ali King.
Most people are not.
That's okay, because tonight we have semifinals and the finals of the Man Mountain Rock Tag Team Classic, and of course, an Iron. Wait, wrong show. Never mind.
I'm actually gonna be all for that.
That's a wrong time frame. I don't know what you're talking about.
The winner gets a neat guitar shaped like the logo of IRM.
NASCAR race where someone gets a guitar. I forget which one it is. I want to say it's Richmond. Ugh. Might be Texas, though. I don't know.
That'd be a great heel turn if somebody just, like, fucking...
I feel like if you win the NASCAR race in Texas, then you just get a gun.
Yeah.
Or diabetes. Wait, that's Mississippi. My bad. All right. Let's start this off, anyways.
If you... All right, good. Thank you for cutting me off there. I did not want to go in further into that because I had a dark one lined up.
Oh, Jesus. No. Okay. All right. Since it's been so long since I've done a universe mode, do I let the fans pick the matches? What should I do here? Let's see how it's set up for us first.
Yeah, well, we might need to...
Oh, boy.
Wait, what's going on here? is this the first... Oh, this is the first delving into on this game, isn't it?
Yeah. Also, new guy, Raven. Oh. I got Raven.
Oh, sold. I'm already sold for that. It's a decent Raven, too. Holy
That's a
shit.
Very good Raven.
Yeah.
God damn.
That's not right.
This is a... What the... What the...
Like shit, aren't they?
What the fuck is this
so
show?
I'm guessing you already have the roster split set up and the belts.
Oh yeah, I'll go over the roster again since this is the first episode. I will show everybody what I got here. 58 people. Actually, you know what? It might be able to show us in the.
I don't think you really need to go through the entire roster. People have been watching these. They know who's on. In fact, you went through it like last time.
I'll just go through really fast. How about that? Okay. That's super fast.
That works.
Super hot.
Okay, let's start out here. Okay, let's go through them one by one. 58 people in total. I converted so everyone can be editable, and I can throw shit on them like King Crowns, looking at you, Tiger Ali Singh. Also, a lot of them have shitty, like, renders that people hacked into them, like Chainsaw Charlie there.
Like Tiger Ali Singh.
Like Tiger Ali Singh, which we'll see in a sec. Oh, yeah, the Mystery Science Theater, Kai and Tai.
Yeah, the MST3K Dojo.
I am not edited. He's Mitchell Funaki, but I have not edited him yet, so just remember that. I don't think you need me telling you that.
I'm very happy for... Eventual Chainsawless Chainsaw Charlie.
Oh yeah, it's gonna happen tonight. We're gonna see it. Sad love.
I am very happy to have been in the conversation that led to the MST3K Dojo.
Yes, I was too fucking.
That was just
good.
The two of us, wasn't it? Like,
yeah, it was me and you.
Like,
we were.
It was like after a WCW stream. We're just
and I was
crying.
Like, I'm
we were,
stealing just, that. By the way,
I was like, oh my god, that needs to happen. It's like, and you were just like, take it, it's yours. I was like, okay.
Then I was like, yoink, motherfuckers. By the way, update. I got shitty 2000 drugged up road dog. So, made
sure
him.
Did. And I just gave you the best tag team just before we started the stream.
Yes, you did.
Which we can't get into just yet. It's a secret.
Mm-hmm. Wow. I made Moppy. That's me. That's all me.
Yep. That's no one else would take credit for that.
So
now, if you could find, you team up Moppy with Mae Young's hand.
You.
Overalls. I'm glad people are digging the overalls, Road Dog. So
That Albert looks like Triple H now.
Yeah, but so we got here. Oh, we got shitty
death.
White.
I hope it's okay that I'm going to give two broads flowers tonight.
Hey. I think we should start off with like a six man. What do you think?
Yes.
What have you learned from universe mode?
There's a 15 minute time limit that I will upheld. Fine, I'll make it a tag match. Tag match. This is 2K14, they fixed it. Like, fucking 13s was unfucking playable, so.
13!
Alright, who should we have here?
They fixed it just to fucking in 15.
Yeah, seriously.
Was it just as bad or was 15 better?
15 was not good.
Not good.
There's hoping 16's good.
Well, I was gonna say, they seem to have good even number years ones.
Yeah, I have hope for 16. Let's do a Chainsaw Charlie and a Cactus.
You know,
I'm sorry.
I got to acknowledge what Mr. Priceless said in the chat. He's acknowledging, he's talking about the TNA, their world title tournament thing. And I was so excited about it. I was like, you know what? It takes a lot for me to actually put faith in TNA for anything. I was like, you know what? Good on them for that one. I'm not going to be, you know, just judgmental because they suck. Like, if they do something good, I'm going to point it out.
Yeah.
And then I hear that, like, one group, it's like World Cup style. So, like, eight groups of four, and then they do, like, you know, then it goes to, like, a 16-man knockout tournament. And then I find out that, like, at least one of the groups is going to have, like, females in it. And I'm like, oh, okay. And there goes the bell.
Okay, guys, what do you think? Should I have just, like, beat the shit out of each other match to start off with here?
Sure.
This is an interesting six-man.
I said I was changing it to a tag match.
Still in this game?
I didn't hear that.
What's up?
Is match creator? Was this the last one that had match creator in it?
It was, yeah.
All right, we can do that. My patented fatal four-way first blood and knockouts elimination hardcore match.
My God.
Or you can have a four-way triple threat.
Ooh. Hey, wait a minute.
Or if you're playing the Wheel of Fortune version, a four-day triple threat.
Yeah.
God.
You understand? Okay, I gotta go back to this.
Puzzle guy had a seizure.
Do you remember that the first time you guys played Wheel of Fortune, not the one where I was on the call,
mm-hmm.
but I believe that was one of the puzzles was a four-way triple threat. I was sitting in a classroom. I was sitting in one of my MBA classes, at George Mason University in Fairfax, Virginia. I was sitting in a class on venture capital class, taught by the assistant dean of the damn program, and I had the stream up, and I'm watching it, and I am trying to just keep composed, as I am aware that nobody is getting this thing right, and I am like seething, and I know that Fitz is on, and I know Will is on, and I'm like, guys, you're blowing it.
I know. I was so mad at myself.
Good times. Yeah, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to distract from that.
You're
like,
good.
That made me think of it just because of the four-day triple threat.
It's a fucking loading screen. It's all right.
Those renders, the render of Terry Funk is really messing with my head.
It's so bad, right?
And my eyes. It's like it's the one part that doesn't look right in that film. It looks askew.
It looks like it's straight out of SmackDown 2.
Yeah, Compton SmackDown 2.
Right, here they come.
I had you should team them up with Tiger Ali Singh.
The kings of the deathmatch?
I mean, his dad, you know.
Oh, yeah! I forgot about his dad. Yeah, that's right.
His dad was fucking terrible.
Yes, he was.
Tiger Jeet Singh was a legend.
This is the fucking worst.
Hey!
I have a tape.
Oh, yeah.
The famous IWA King of the Deathmatch.
Wasn't
Tiger Jeet Singh is god awful in that.
Isn't Dan Severn on that show?
He is. He faces Tarzan Goto. I might have to seek that that tape out and find it and watch it.
Terry,
or you just find a better copy of it online.
Terry Funk has his fucking Barbra Streisand's nose song, so we're not changing that shit.
Right.
But I know what you're talking about. Every night when I step into the ring, I can still hear the people.
Oh, are you sure he shouldn't come out to that song about how much he hates school?
I'm gonna punch my girlfriend right in the face.
Yeah, seriously.
I'm gonna sock that old broad right in the nose. The actual line from that song.
It's weird, like, hearing Terry Funk speak without hearing random Japanese women going, Daddy!
Emma! Cat on the keyboard is so fucking good.
Now listen, Brashaw, we're going to start this match on the roof.
Oh my god.
And then we're going to work our way down, you son of a bitch.
I just realized my Terry Funk is dangerously close to near the end of his life, career-wise, Groucho Marx.
Oh, really? That's so funny.
You know, when
up.
He was doing the variety show loop and interview
yeah.
show loop, and they didn't have the wherewithal to just not get put a microphone in front of him.
Oh, just so loopy.
Yeah, because the stories he was on made no sense whatsoever.
I remember that time, me and Jesus.
me, Jesus, and Larry Fine were all partying.
I was going to say, it's
It was me, Jesus, and Harpo.
Yeah, and who?
And Harpo.
Harpo.
And we were gonna go get a sandwich.
My God.
Oh my God, drunk Terry Funk.
Terry drunk. More like Terry drunk. So over under. So is Bradshaw gonna take a strap on the Terry Funk in the showers?
He's damn well better.
Now note I said strap on because I imagine Bradshaw will do this thing where he put the strap on his butt and it'll like kinda like go butt to butt with a dude.
He just goes ass to ass.
Ass to ass. Ass to ass.
Yeah, Steve Bonaventure came out.
Yeah, of
that name was, yeah.
It was Cat on the Key. NTQ is dead on correct. It was Cat on the Keyboard. The puzzle was, because I was playing the bonus round for that one, Cat on the Keyboard, and it was as if the puzzle was trying to write steak dinner, but of course it was steak dinner.
Steak din cue.
Yeah, oh, like, there's like three cues in a row or something like that.
We're going hardcore here. Without any weapons,
and
but...
Caveman's first guess was Steve Bonaventure for some reason.
Amazing.
And I was like, okay, well, that's got to be a name for
those
something.
Those are the because... fucking days, I'll tell you what. Boy, I'll tell you what. Yeah, if I could put the fucking Always Pounding Ass t-shirts in this game, you know that they'd be wearing them right now. I hope you know that, guys.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, everyone would be wearing PH.
Damn.
Pounding ass, pounding ass, pounding ass.
All right, so we got Raw, SmackDown, and Hardcore Heat. No more shotguns, no more snort guns Saturday night, sadly. It's Hardcore Heat. It just sounds better, so I'm going with that.
Because you're never going to have somebody do a tombstone on, like, an escalator.
Nah, we can't have... which, by the way... Shotgun Saturday Night. That was Undertaker and Hunter Hearst Helmsley. I remember that.
Was it Triple H dead too?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, Triple H. Yeah, Triple H was the one that got Tombstone because because that was after the curtain call.
No, that was such a ridiculous show.
I loved it. Fucking Marlena Shotgun getting her Seth tits Hurt. Out in front of Ahmed Johnson and shit.
Shotgun Saturday Night was such a good idea and just such a clusterfuck.
Yeah, like fucking...
What were you saying about Ahmed Johnson?
Ahmed Johnson looking at like fucking Marlena's titties during a match of Goldust or
something. No, that was the Sultan, dude.
Was that the Sultan? Okay.
Like, it was the Sultan.
Pardon me for getting my fucking 97 gimmicks mixed up. You all know I know a lot about...
Sisters of Love.
Oh, man. Maybe I should get the Sisters of Love for this instead of that. Well, nah, we got Beaver Cleavage. I gotta keep him around.
Yeah. What are we going to do with Thrasher?
He'll probably find a new...
headbanger.
We got to find another headbanger.
I'm going to hold...
We're going to make a new headbanger.
Joke. I'm going to tear hold in my terrible joke.
Oh, no. Headbanger funk.
Did I just say it, Fitz?
Yeah, go
I'm
ahead.
I feel terrible about this. My other... Well, you need another headbanger, so why not the blue blazer? I felt so bad about that.
Small package!
I'm sorry.
Yeah, Pillman, shit fetish Brian Pillman will be here tonight as well, I'm guessing. I'll have him in something.
He's going to yank out his Johnson.
And shit in this hellhole.
And
I'm
shit out of his dick.
I'm going to yank out my asshole and shit.
Oh, man. Ew, he's got. Yeah, he got his pink socks on for tonight's show.
Ew. Oh, my God. You got to give him the Mr. Socko finisher and the pink Socko.
Oh, Jesus.
Fucking... Oh, God.
He'd reach into his ass and pull out a pink sock.
You have to give this now. It's got to be his finisher.
Yeah.
It has to be the mandible claw.
The stink finger claw.
He was feuding with Dude Love, so it makes sense. The only feud I'm carrying over, by the way, from the old mode. As far as I'm concerned, okay. That's non-canon now. This is the reboot.
So you've already set up a bunch of tag teams and whatnot?
Yeah, everyone's set up here.
Oh, yeah.
Right, oh, good. Two count here. Tell you, the fucking tag teams are not as insufferable here, so it actually plays well. What do we got going on here, though?
Leave you. I totally believe you.
Clothesline from hell! This has got to be it!
Oh, no!
Heck.
Ah, Terry Funk breaks it up, though. Nick of time, because he got thrown out, I believe.
Whoa, that is racist.
I said Nick of time. Nick.
Oh.
Not neighbor.
Not Dolph Ziggler's other finisher.
Jesus. Oh, Mandible Claw. I don't know why Cactus Jack has that, but he's got it locked on.
He's got him in the bang bang.
Oh.
He used that as, he used that in WWE as Cactus Jack.
Did he?
I mean,
okay.
He just didn't give a shit at that point.
Yeah, he's like, I don't know what
Corey's
I am.
He was just like, whatever. I'll fucking
call me
do
what,
it.
Call me whatever you want. Just don't call me late for supper.
Supper.
What is this, 518? The previous attitude mode can be taken in broad strokes, whatever the funniest. Yeah. A lot of goofy shit happened during that, though. But, fresh news. Mm-hmm. We got 50 people. Holy shit.
Yeah.
Nice. 50 million.
Supper's canceled.
Supper's canceled.
According to Joe Mo, supper's canceled.
That's what Terry Funk would say. Sounds like something he'd say. Supper's canceled, kid.
Yeah.
The Double Cross Ranch is closed.
Jesus.
We got some pictures here. Various reactions to Brian's headbanger joke. Yeah.
Oh, no.
Oh, Terry Funk flicking the bird to Farouk.
I feel like Australian soft rock duo Air Supply would appreciate that.
I should get another fucking soft rock duo to support Attitude Mode. Who should I get?
Oh, come on. You're stealing everything.
No! The fucking boys down south are stealing all of our stars, like the Nacho Man and, like...
Excuse me?
The Huckster.
You must be watching the third hour of Nitro.
Fine. Fine. 1-2-3 Kid, Aldo Montoya. I'll fucking know. Oh.
Super Dave will never not be outraged.
Shaw getting the hot tag here.
You wrote that? I mean, I just read it. You read that?
Oh, shit, Cactus.
I'm not a part of this.
Cactus corner countered it. He corner countered it.
Boom!
I've never actually seen that countered.
I have not either.
Did he really just counter the hot tag spot? Not the
he
hot
did.
Tag, like the,
Yeah, he did.
That's crazy.
That's been a good match so
He's
far.
He's like, fuck your hot tag. Psychology.
Psych!
Yeah, not enough. You have not missed enough Brockus matches. Do you have Brockus?
Fuck no. Why'd I... No.
Why not?
Because Brockus is
I really
want
to do a WBF universe mode.
That'd be fucking funny.
Scary Stridum.
Wow!
But it really does mean I have to, watch a WBF show to get all the guys.
Bear hug from Terry Funk. What the fuck is this?
I learned that from hugging an actual bear.
Oh, counter to a fucking DDT. Jesus, Bradshaw.
It turned out to just be Tracy Smothers in a bear suit.
Yo. Freddie Joe Floyd, though.
That's right. That was, in fact, Christ.
Good way to start this off. I'm happy about this. It's making me excited.
Talking about Freddie Joe Floyd.
No, this fucking match. That's not some good shit. Oh, big ol' superplex.
Basically, the answer to that is England Dan not impressed. John Ford Coley unsure why England Dan brought him to see this.
An unbreakable. Oh wow!
So for Terry Funk to go for a crazy moonsault.
Yeah, it's gonna be nuts when that happens.
Oh god, that's right. He would always do that, wouldn't he?
No.
Terry Funk doing springboard moonsaults was the craziest.
The
fucking
shit.
Thing.
That is the shit, man. I love it.
I still remember seeing him take the suplex onto the folding chairs in the Royal Rumble.
Oh, yeah. My God.
And the way he sold
just
it. Like,
shaking.
I had never seen someone take a chair spot like that.
You get it shaking like Parkinson's?
That was the first time I've ever seen a chair spot.
Really?
Yeah, he started just shaking and, like, I was just like, oh, my God, he just murdered himself.
Oh, I just punched fucking Shaw right in the fucking face.
Congrats.
Oh, last second, Farouk breaks it up.
Dang.
Damn. Oh, that was a fucking 2 9/10. Oh, full Nelson. If you listen to WrestleMania 8, you'll know that that's named after Lord Nelson, another full Nelson.
Yes, a very fat person.
Oh, folks, I'm right in the fucking... Oh, right in the dick!
Nelson Mandela, actually. It was named after Nelson Mandela.
He's dead! He punched him right in the balls! Oh, and Cactus Chainsaw Charlie gets it after punching Farouk right in the dick.
I hope. Oh my God, the ball shot was the finish, wasn't it?
The dirtiest chainsaw in the game.
Wow, that was a good fucking match.
By the way, drink everybody for that fucking tag.
Ding.
Move.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, dropped a whole down.
Nice to see they're ripping that off from us.
Yeah. He punched him in the strap on. You're goddamn right he did.
All I'm saying is WCW Universe Mode has been doing the drop toe hold arm elbow drop for years.
Taz! No. Ron! What is it?
What is it?
My balls, Maggle! I can see that. Should have worn a cup or something. Damn. Friends. They love
Sorry
it.
Sorry about your damn balls.
Well, I'll be damn.
I know it's not them, but... They're buddies.
Pallies. Even though they...
I know, John, I
even though they murder each other, they're friends.
It's like that scene in Robin Hood Men in Tights. Watch my back. Your back just got punched twice.
Do not fucking point at me, Seamus. Put your... I don't know where that finger's been. I don't want to smell it. Okay, next match. What should I do next? Singles match?
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll let you guys, since you're the only two in here right now, I'll let you guys pick who's in the match.
Hmm.
Oh, Pasco's in here too, but I think you're muted, buddy. Alright, who do you guys want? We'll have him feud off here. Could be anyone you want.
Well, I'm gonna go ahead and make this a little on the general side. Since they just won the wild card and won their first playoff game in like a long time, someone associated with Chicago. Do you have anyone associated with Chicago? No.
I hear Steven Regal drove through Chicago once.
Well, we could always, on the other hand, we could always instead.
Al Snow's from Ohio. Does that work? No! Is Ahmed Johnson? I got it.
D'Lo. Yeah, D'Lo's from Chicago.
Is D'Lo from Chicago? I didn't know where he's. Okay, we'll go D'Lo then. Chest protector, because I'm not. Yeah, D'Lo. Okay.
You ain't fucking around.
Yeah. The third member of the Gangstas.
Yes.
Yeah. He didn't wrestle Undertaker. That may have wrestled Undertaker.
And totally but... not one half of the current Chikara Campeones de Parejas.
Nope. All right. Blake, who do you want?
Oh, man.
No, I got an idea. Blake, you think of who
you
want.
What do you got?
Triple threat. Chat chooses someone.
Okay.
So, let's see what we got here. By the way, they are elimination, these triple threats, so don't worry. They won't go on 97 years.
You mean they're three-way dances?
Yes.
I'm a stickler for that. I was so glad I got to talk to somebody. Like, somebody actually was like, there is a difference, right? I'm like, I'm pretty sure that's when it's an elimination. I was like, yes, that's exactly what it is. It's an elimination.
I'm getting a lot of dance.
Hey.
I'm getting a lot of Dan Severn in the chat right now.
Chat wants Dan Severn, so Blake, you still got
Dan Severn.
You got D'Lo Brown, you got Dan Severn.
If I remember correctly, the third person that was involved in that little scroll was Steve Blackman.
You're correct.
I don't see why not.
All right, let's fucking do this. D-
That's when he was the Lord of the Dance.
There was also this early thing.
Seriously, like, was a wrestling chat I was in way back then, and everyone just referred to him as Lord of the Dance, Steve Blackman. That was what the music sounded like.
There was also the, shit, I think I fucked up here. Hold on. There was also Blackman's first theme.
That was the first wrestling theme I ever downloaded.
Oh, and he basically just like sprinted down to the ring all the time.
Yeah, in like 97, 98.
Where he was the Lethal Weapon. And then after that, appropriate enough, he got too old for this shit.
Yeah. I like how his entrance video is just like him swinging the like Lone Dark Kendo sticks. And it's like, martial artist. Just said martial artist, Steve Blackman.
Yeah, he does the martial arts. He should have teamed up with a guy named Martial Arts.
That would have been good.
Yeah. It would have been progressive. Very, very ahead of its time.
I love this, like, hell background I have for this, because there's no old Raw in this, so I had to make do, but Universe has to also, so I don't mind.
I mean, have you seen what I've been doing for WCW Universe mode?
A bit. I may have seen it once or twice.
Perhaps more than that.
Like?
Woo! Your ass is dead meat, victory is sweet, bring it on. What you gonna do about it?
Now, was that D-Lo's theme or an old lady doing sound effects on Who's Lawn?
Carol Channing.
That's a really good reference.
Thank
Jesus
you.
Christ. Fucking sound effect. No, don't. Not you, Blake.
Oh, me? Oh, goddamn. I was like, yeah, Carol
Channing. The old woman doing sound effects game.
Oh, just doing the same sound for everything.
Oh, shit. I do remember that now.
We better close this door.
It's like a
this
goo.
Phone is haunted.
It's like a goo noise for each fucking thing. Some old broad they pulled from
the
audience.
Rip on the fucking audience.
Mood just changed, guys. There he fucking is.
Oh no.
There he fucking is.
I thought the mood about the change was.
Nah, he's not here yet, buddy.
Hazards.
Note I said yet.
Man, that's a nice new shirt. He hasn't sweat through that one yet.
Not yet.
Probably because I couldn't get the effect well in this mode.
Yeah, New Blackjacks had a great theme too.
It was apparently it's the same as Justin Hawk Bradshaw's music.
It is not.
Oh,
it was the same as Dr. Death though. I actually have a Dan Severn autograph, by the way. Little fun fact. I in fact do. Just like we're all, that's not Howard Finkel. Who the fuck's that? Tony Chimmel.
Some guy who just
Tony
from the crowd.
Yeah, we're gonna rip you off down south. That's Tony Chimmel at the tapeworm. How do you feel about that? Justin Roberts in the background.
I mean, it's a man with a tapeworm. I wouldn't be too proud of that.
Time traveling Justin Roberts.
I mean, you need to be pretty low to capitalize on a man with a tapeworm.
Don't.
Lethal weapon, martial artist.
Lethal weapon.
Spinning shit.
I do hope that one day we see Steve Blackman in Lethal Weapon 7.
Oh my god.
Yes.
He's too old for this.
Go suck an egg.
Do you realize how close we were to Steve Blackman Bounty Hunter as a program?
So sad.
That could have been a thing. And yet, the focus group dorked it all up.
Ugh.
I wanted to see Steve Blackman chase down Perps.
I am the black, the big black man. The big
I forget what the term for guys who bounty hunters are sent after.
Bail bonds?
Bail bonds are usually is the business, but I mean, right. There's kind of like a slang term for when they when they're kind of skipping.
Fugitives?
I think they just call them skips.
Skips.
They're skips. I think.
Is there any wrestlers named Skip?
And I only know this because Skip of the Bayless? Joe Schmo Show season 3, which is when they which was the gimmick of find the next best bounty hunter. Which
that's
amazing.
Incredible.
Dude, the whole thing was great. It was an amazing, amazing show.
That sounds it. Skip Sheffield, yeah. Skip Sheffield
especially
versus Steve Blackman.
Especially because they brought it back. Especially because they brought it back after so many years of it being gone.
Appeal forgot about it. So Appeal wouldn't get suspicious of it. Well, D'Lo's getting his ass beat right now.
I think we all saw that coming.
Yeah.
Just like in the original program.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
Jesus, scissor kick.
Back fist.
Super kick. Super kick. Oh my god.
American males. Are you talking about Steven Regal? I don't know who that could be.
I want Severn and Blackman to be your new Young Bucks.
That would be amazing.
I just want an unlikely team to become the new your Young Bucks.
I really hope something like that happens.
Yeah.
And it, like, just like you get in a ridiculous team, but then you just repurpose them as like Young Bucks. Mm-hmm. I don't know who yet, but we'll figure it out.
Kurgan and Grangle, Jesus.
Kurgan Buck and Grangle Buck, or Jackson, Grangle Jackson.
Grangle Jackson. Are you fucking?
Grangle Jackson is like the worst blaxploitation name ever.
Grangle Jackson, are you fucking
so
kidding
Grangle
me?
Jackson. Excuse me?
Is Pasco in here, by the way? Because he's in here, but he's not talking. Let me ask the man if he's okay. Pasco, you okay? Gringle Jackson, though. Bop. Jesus, Severn! Fuck! Okay.
Oh. Ah!
And to the shock of no one, Dan Severn is murdering people.
Fuck. Oh, whose original move is that?
I have no clue. I think it might be Ryback.
That's fucking
I think I've seen
brutal.
Ryback do that before, yeah.
That's fucking brutal as hell.
They gotta hit him really hard to get through the fucking chest protector, too.
Oh, yeah. Now,
it's like an armadillo.
Have the titles already been set?
Yes, the world champion is Dude Love. He beat Pillman at the last show. Oh, okay. Shit. That was an unnecessary break by D'Lo there. The hardcore champion is Hardcore Holly, representing the Hugger Oranges. Mm-hmm. Tag champs are Supply and Demand. That is Val Venus and the Godfather. And the newly crowned European champion is Big Boss Man.
Oh, yeah, Big Boss Man.
And the Intercontinental champion is Draws, because it's the Attitude Era, and there needs to be 97 fucking titles, so.
And you have a king.
And we have a king. King of the Ring is Tiger Ali Singh. Cause Tiger Ali okay. King. So, yep.
Singh is king.
Have fun with that.
I can't wait for Hardcore Heat so I can see a silly hardcore match.
Multiple silly hardcore matches. The gimmick stands, random competitors each match, so that stays. All
right.
Super kick.
Oh, you just hit the random button?
Yeah.
It works.
I like it. I like it because it gives the appearance that like everyone is waiting backstage. Just waiting to the waiting to be picked.
Fucking Dan Severn just murdered D'Lo.
It's kind of like how WCW just like brought everyone to the show, even though like
They didn't need
80
it.
80 of the 100 people they bought got paid and didn't get used.
Yeah. And the Shock of No One, just after that kick to the fucking face, D'Lo's out.
Just
super kick.
Just 60 people standing, just 60 people sitting in Gorilla waiting for their spot.
Yes.
It's like at fucking Starrcade 97, everyone was like in the crowd.
That's right.
Just Rey Mysterio looking sad during a fucking, like, match between fucking, like, Big Boss Man and the Steiners against Macho Man, Virgil, and Scott Norton.
Oh, man, that sounds... Oh,
God. That actually, that hearing that made me tired.
That is it's pretty fucking rough, guys. Oh, another big kick. This is a fucking super kick party here.
Super kick!
Like, for real.
I know.
Oh, Steve Blackman gonna put away Dan Severn here? Let's see. Oh! Got a replay out of it. Oh, wow, Steve Blackman
Not
wins!
Huh!
Cool.
Good!
Don't fuck up the lethal weapon.
After he kicked him in the face and broke his back.
Yeah!
His ass.
Fatality.
Forget he fucked his ass.
Made him humble, old country lay.
Fucking the ass is important.
Yeah, I say it before they do, so. That's how it works. Saying that's how it works for everybody.
Yeah, because basically, and that's how all these things work. Like, all these streamy guys work. Basically, yeah. So, there is a delay. So, Fitz obviously is playing it locally, so he's seeing it as it's happening, just as I am when it's me doing universe mode.
Yeah.
The delay is only 5 seconds, we believe, which is way better than Twitch puts. That's part of the reason why the crossover happens, because just the delay is so much
better. It was rotten.
Yeah.
Those are the old times.
So Blake and I are seeing it as you guys are.
Right.
So unfortunately, because we're seeing it when you guys are, we're both reacting at the same time. Like, y'all are in the chat are reacting, and so are we on the call, but you're hearing us react 5 seconds after you've seen it. So that's what happens, but nothing you can do about that.
Okay. I got a request from NTQ. I think it's time to see Mystery Science Theater Kaientai.
MST3K Dojo,
Six-man tag?
Yeah, six-man tag. We'll try it out here. 15-minute time limit on every match, so it's not a big...
Yeah, good.
Big
yes.
Hassle. No rope breaks, so don't have to worry about that either. So yeah, let's do this shit.
Their interest theme is this Torgo's Marsh song from Manos.
God.
Oh my god. I'm gonna look that up now.
I'll have Funaki next time, because I don't have him ready.
Torgo's theme.
Search for the same.
All right, what team should they face? I think it should be a thrown together one.
Yes.
So.
Hit Thrasher.
Oh my god! It basically is.
I'm gonna get
Manos.
That weird goat man.
Let's do Grangle.
Manos. The most famous quote ever by somebody named The Hands of Fate.
Yes. Right. Manos, The Hands of Fate? Dick Torgo. Is it Funaki or is it Soul Taka?
It's
Soul Taka.
Did you give him a bigger chin? Is that what happened?
No, I just threw that. He's fucking Joe Estevez from that, not the other one. Okay, who else should be in this fucking thrown together team here? I got Grangle. I want Grangle, so.
Grangle. trying to think of who was always just thrown in. Test.
Stone Cold. Who are you kidding?
God.
Who do you think I'm wrestling? Blade Stab? Oh, no. God, I gave him the, get one of the Kubernetes fun first. God damn it. Punch Rock Groin? What? Stump Chunkman? What? Buck Drinklots? What?
Stump.
Make large huge? What?
Somebody's wanting Rope the fucking Steve, British.
What?
The fucking British Bulldog. Let's do it.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Is this Blue Jeans British Bulldog?
You're goddamn right it is. I'll show you something. Let me go.
Fucking Blue Jeans.
Let me go back, because I need to show you guys something. Each, like, so, like, each attire I made and then copied over into the main slot, so,
No longer bizarre. He's bizarre. He's bizarre.
I'll show you what I did here.
Oh, I see Gilbert.
Gilbert, yeah. Do you want Gilbert instead of Test?
Sure. Save Test for bigger and better things.
Of course.
Lord. So Gilbert, Grangle, and who did I pick again?
British Bulldog. Now look at this shit.
Watch
this. The blue jeans attire I listed as this.
I love that picture of Gilbert, by the way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dead soon.
it's disturbingly true.
Mm-hmm. All right. And play. Yeah, Test was fucking awesome. He was good.
Yes.
He is super. Until he started fucking roided up.
Yeah.
I was gonna say, yeah, then what happened? It was the roids, right?
Yeah, roids got to him. That was like when he started wrestling like Scott Steiner and shit. Post Un-Americans, yeah. Basically. Yeah, Test is fucking awesome. Here Comes the Pain, too. I'm a fan of Test, only not Roidy Test. 2006 Roidy Magoo is fucking terrible, yeah. The former bodyguard for Motley Crue. Yeah. Who is your favorite guys to play as in Here Comes the Pain? Because mine is probably Rhino. Blake, Brian, do you have a pick?
What are we picking? Sorry.
Here Comes the Pain. Who is your favorite? Here Comes the Pain character.
I didn't really play Here Comes the Pain. I played the one before.
I was wondering. Yeah. Shut your mouth.
And honestly, I did so much of it. I did so much in the creator wrestler stuff that I barely played as anyone in the actual game.
True.
That's fair. There they are, guys.
MSTPK did it. Yes, and look at them.
Had to give them the 3MB entrance.
What a bunch of goobers.
Just don't call them what Big Show called them on that fucking SmackDown. They got it censored.
I'm pretty sure he called him something else.
Oh, yeah. It wasn't Goofs, I'll tell you that.
Oh, no.
They had to censor it. Yeah, that actually fucking happened.
My God. Who said that?
Big Show.
Oh.
All I know is it rhymed with books.
Oh, no. Crooks?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, man. It's slander.
Who's, as was you two, right, that came up with this shit? How's it feel to, like, have it, like, play out in front of you?
What's up?
Didn't you two fucks come up with that gimmick?
Yeah, it's kind
this? Of this. Yeah. Right, here I'm very happy with this.
All right, here comes Gringle. Can't call him the other name because the White Wolf.
I'm not entirely certain what. Yeah, because it's not our property. It's somebody. That name is somebody else's property.
We're not entirely sure Hughes anymore.
Yeah, exactly. It's somebody Inc. I don't know who anymore.
Call me Kurt Grangle. Call me Kurt Grangle. He has an alternate lifestyle, Kang. He goes to bike clubs. Wait a minute, that's Kevin Thorne. Never mind. Hey, you got a little mess on your.
Yeah, that was
fine.
It's fine. I should have sex to the Breed music. That'd be awesome.
Yeah.
Just fucking. I have to be near a fucking light source so I can switch the light on and off to add effect.
Just constantly flipping the light switch on and off.
Oh, here comes Gilbert.
Oh man. Oh no.
Gilbert. Legitimately though, another reason I switched over is because this game had Goldberg's entrance and I wanted that shit.
I forgot it did. Oh my god.
Fuck you guys down south. He gets actual pyro now. Gilbert.
Went forward to spear somebody and just bounce off ineffectively.
Oh my god, that was always the fucking best. Former light heavyweight champion, by the way. Then Dean Malenko beat the piss out of him. They actually started doing stuff with it again.
Yeah.
So yeah, you got a Stone Cold Bobby Eaton, I heard, down there. I think it's only fair. Oh, here comes Bulldog. I wonder if he has more charisma here or now.
Uncomfortable silence, British Bulldog.
Yeah, seriously. Just he's gonna die soon, guys. And you can kind of notice it.
Woof, 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 woof.
No, no, no. Now. Yeah, how fucking generic is this goddamn song? If you can tell slightly, you can see his gear poking out, like his tights. Poking out from his jeans.
Oh, yeah.
A kind of sign of what he once was. Not dead.
Very much alive.
Did you ever watch Eastbound and Down, Blake?
No, I didn't.
There's a scene where Kenny sings, "I'm still alive" at a funeral. You can see his chub poking out of his jeans. That's fucking disgusting.
No.
Not fine with that. Great. What's that?
Nah.
Were you about to talk about Heidenreich? Because it sounded like you're about to say Heidenreich.
I wasn't planning on it.
Well, we are now. Will can do fucking yeah. Will can do fucking Ruthless Aggression Mode, and he can take Heidenreich. I feel like everyone's gonna get assigned a mode here. I got Attitude, Brian has WCW.
What am I gonna wind up with?
I don't know. What is Brian still here? Brian?
Yeah.
Are you still here with us?
Yeah, I'm kinda dozing off a little bit.
That's what I thought. Who did we assign modes to?
What do you mean mode?
Like how we were saying, like, yeah.
It was mostly as a gag, but yeah. We were just giving away the shitty ones to our friends. That's what it was.
I feel like I'm going to wind up getting ECW.
No, no, don't worry. That one's spoken for.
Damn.
No, don't trust me. It's going to be all right. I think, didn't we give Ben one of the Ben's Jersey All-Pro mode?
Yeah, Ben has Jersey All-Pro mode. What the fuck? Gangrel and Gilbert working as a team here. Right. Oh, and that spear did nothing. Good job, Gilbert. You fucking suck. Okay. Yeah, Ben has Jersey All-Pro mode.
We had to give Pasco something shitty, too.
Pasco should get, like, 90... Pasco gets 90 on WCW with, like, fucking Shockmaster and Rat. And
a little bit.
New generation mode would be money. Freddy Joe Floyd, Pasco Tailhopper.
We can give Pasco Memphis.
Memphis, yeah. Fucking Christmas creature and shit. Are you kidding me? If this is the end of the match, I'm gonna laugh so fucking hard. Mm. Oh, no, it's not. Dick Togo really wrecking the. Oh, I'm sorry. Dick Torgo really wrecking the competition here.
I know.
Fucking hell!
His legs are looking a little weirder nowadays.
Yeah, a little. I think he's been doing squats or something. I think every day's been leg day for him. I don't know.
Yeah, it's kind of weird.
Early about the legs.
Oh my god, Salvatore Sincere. Fuck. And British Bulldog doing absolutely fucking nothing. XPW, John Barber gets XPW. Rabbit Raccoon. I think we all could tell you that. What the fuck, Gilbert? Okay, you can do that, I guess. It's fine, it's a video game.
Yep.
Jean-Pierre Lafitte, Isaac Yankum. I wonder if people have made... I'll have to check later. I get fucking early CZW, I don't know about you. I'll take that.
Damn.
No, George Gatton can get early CZW. Yeah, he would get that.
Wrestling superstar George Gatton can get a.
What about Russo era WCW bro? Foster can get that since he was at the episode of Thunder where David Arquette won the belt.
Bless his heart, I would have wanted to be there.
Just to make him replay that with David Arquette in the mode each time. What the fuck?
Mm-hmm.
What? Wait for it. Wow. I can't even be mad at that. That was fucking insane.
What?
Ah!
The damnedest spear I ever did see.
Oh my god.
Gilbert fucking murdered everyone in that match.
Oh my god.
I don't think he tagged in, honestly. No, he had to have, because Gangrel's starting it off. What the fuck?
Keep that man away from the belt. He will win every single one of them.
No kidding, Jesus.
Part of me kind of wants to see that happen.
And British Bulldog did fucking fuck all. Yeah, WWF doesn't understand parody. They just got a guy to actually destroy people. Look at Gangrel taking all the... Look at Bulldog taking all the credit. He's in the middle of them.
He did literally nothing that I remember.
He actually did nothing. You're right.
He was there for motivational support.
You can do it. What a bizarre finish. Alright, so Bart Gunn and Big Boss Man. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna make this a fucking title match, playa. Big Boss Man won the belt in a Royal Rumble for it. So
I remember that.
Good thing about Boss Man is I got this in here too, so if I ever need it.
Oh, classic Bossman.
Yeah. Big Bossman.
Dude, I went months ago. I went back and watched some of this when he did a few matches in Japan, and the most ridiculous thing. I think he had a very good match with Kobashi.
Yes, he did. He in fact did, yeah.
Expressionless Bart Gunn.
Well, he's so concussed, he doesn't feel anymore.
Oh, yeah. He has lost the ability to actually feel.
All the nerve ending in his face are just, like, shot. He can't do shit anymore. Including shit. He just kind of pees poop. His organs were knocked about by that punch.
Oh, yeah. It's an enemy out chase due to excessive concussions. God.
Oh, my God. Hey, Big Show, I got feelings too. Member of the corporation, I believe. I don't think there's a corporation team. There used to be, but I got rid of it. It was Test. And
yeah,
I don't think there's a need for it, so.
Test and Shamrock and Bossman.
Mm-hmm. Patterson and Briscoe could possibly, but they're doing their own thing with their team, so I'm not gonna.
Yeah. Man, how great was Big Boss Man's car with the Big Blues Brothers speaker system on the roof?
Oh my God, one of my earliest memories of wrestling is like seeing that. For real. It was that and the fucking dog poop match with Mankind and
Oh yeah.
Rock, Mankind, and Bulldog. Where they're like scooping up.
Match.
Yeah. Because I just remember, man, one of the memories was Mankind was just wearing bright blue fucking pants during that, so.
Oh yeah.
And Bart could not find a Bart robe, so he had to find a Bart one. So, all out of Bart.
I heard he had to fight off four other people in a laundromat, each of them trying to get that robe.
Bart robes are very hard to come by, so.
Yes. Mm-hmm. They're in high demand.
Throwing them up. One good thing is they left Mike Tyson's entrance in, so. It's for the strap! Why is Bart Gun Pikachu? I don't get this. Oh yeah, also, the dog poop, the dog poop, the dog poop, rock bottom into the dog poop. Good job, Michael Cole, good job. Now what was Michael Cole's finest moment? Getting a dick in his butt from Heidenreich or that call? Or has he done something else that's more worthy of it?
I don't know. That's a tough one.
This is fantastic. 5-star WrestleMania classic that just tore the house down with Jerry Lawler, of course.
Oh, he's definitely deserving of a Holly Covenant slot on the show.
I mean, Meltzer gave it 4 4.5 out of 5 stars just because of, like, no Tokyo Dome, but, like, still, it's pretty fucking good.
Eh.
Now, one thing I've always been confused... Oh, yes! Jerry Lawler's anal bleeding with a disgusted Booker T next to him. And I think Brian has gone to a bed.
I wouldn't doubt it.
I'm here.
Oh, there we go.
I'm just like dozing in and out. I'm listening and I'm here. I'm just kind of
stay awake. You're gonna fucking stay awake. You're gonna be okay. Keep saying goddamn words.
I'm just being a wrestling observer.
How many stars are you gonna give this one, mate?
I don't know. The galaxy.
There was a fuck. I was listening to like a fucking here. I was reading a Heroes of Wrestling review, and it was like, Meltzer. Yep. Somebody told me it was like, I listened to the Attitude Era podcast doing a review of that, and they said that like, Brian Alvarez said that it was negative every star in the galaxy, and the galaxy is infinite. I believe was what the line was. Boss man going to work here on a Bort. Yeah, I don't see this going good for Bart here. Oh, big boot.
Hmm. You think it's bad now? Wait till he's knocked literally stupid by Butterbean.
Which I gotta do at some point. And that was a quick fucking squash match.
Meh. Bossman looking strong.
He is a Euro champion.
For a reason.
You got to. Pika is that disorder where you eat inanimate objects. Okay. Oh, wait, we got a handshake here. I don't know how... Oh, man, Bart Gunn denying the handshake from Boss Man.
Oh, man.
What a sore fucking loser. Alright, let's go to the main event here. We're gonna skip SmackDown tonight because of the local affiliates, and we're just gonna go straight to Hardcore Heat. So yeah.
Oh man.
Alright, what should the main event be?
So do we want to go with something that actually could main event, or
something in
something
our world
that never would?
Something in our world that would. I'm thinking Ahmed Johnson needs to be involved.
Oh, yeah. But not Al Snow.
No, oh, no, no. You know what? I have an idea. We will have
a
number one contender match. It'll be a battle royal, and it'll be for the Intercontinental title.
Sold.
What we're gonna do is have an over-the-top rope battle royal for a number one contendership. But the catch is, they're gonna start outside of the ring. So they gotta go in. No, I'm not actually gonna do that, don't worry. did I break my game?
I hope not.
Oh, it froze on me. Good job, 2K. Well, they just picked it up from THQ, so I don't blame them. Okay, I'm gonna throw the thing on.
Yeah.
Be back in two shakes of a lamb's dick.
Technological differences.
Yeah. Alright, let me actually get up like a fucking old person and actually press the button on my PS2 here. Yeah, it couldn't handle what I was booking here, so let me restart this. There we go. Okay, walk back around here to my computer. While I do this, I'll get something set up here. See if we can get a third person in here. I might regret doing this, but we'll see.
Oh no.
Okay, we're back. Let me just fucking hook this bullshit back up when getting back in the game. It just couldn't handle it. While we wait, let's think about people we want in this match.
How many people are going to be in this match?
Six.
Ooh, alright. No. Are you looking for people that were specifically involved with the IC title? Are we starting our own nonsensical bullshit here?
That's a weird bullshit. Like I said, Ahmed Johnson is going to be in. Was Ahmed Johnson ever IC champ?
I think he was. I'm looking that up now.
People want beaver cleavage.
Yeah, he had the belt one time. He also had something called the Kuwait Cup.
Yeah, he didn't. That's where Vader got locked up.
And he also had a slamming award for new sensation of the squared circle.
I remember his speech for that. It was like, this is your. So he's not. This is for you. This is your award.
The new sensation, Ahmed Johnson.
Are you ready for a new sensation? New sensation.
Ahmed Johnson. The Kuwait Cup.
The Kumquat Quup. The Kumquat Quup.
Kumquat
Quup.
Do we have the artist formerly known as Goldust?
Yes, we do. Kinda. I'll show you what I got.
Splendid. Do you have that one? Hope he has that checker. That one checkerboard.
I'm gonna make that shit for him. So. We got Kurgan. Yeah.
Throw Kurgan in there.
Yeah. Why not? Don't freeze, don't freeze. And it froze again! Note to self, don't do battle royals in this game.
I wonder why it does that, that's weird.
Oh.
Yeah, it's odd.
Is it too many CAW stuff?
Possibly, I don't know.
Could be.
I'll reset this then, and you know what? We're gonna have it be a ladder match, not a battle royal anymore.
Okay.
Maybe that won't break it.
If down to four people?
It will break you. Yeah, I'll do four people, so it's not a complete clusterfuck. Ahmed Johnson, Kurgan, Beaver Cleavage, and who else do we want? Oh, you said Goldust, right?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll do that then. Ahmed, Beaver, Goldust, and who's the fourth one?
Kurgan?
Kurgan, yeah.
One of these things is not like the other. One of these things is not the same.
Yeah, Kurgan's kind of tall, isn't he?
Yeah, he sure is.
Also, Brian, you still there?
Mm-hmm.
While we're waiting,
mm-hmm.
I will show off the WCW Universe mode logo I've been working on. There you go. I have to add the IRM logo at the bottom, but yeah.
There's a delay, so give me a second. Ah, look at that.
Ooh! Yeah.
I like it.
And when it was small before you just made it larger, uh-huh. About that little circle at the bottom, it was like the plate of the hardcore weight title.
Oh!
Not that I know what it looks like, I have no idea what it looks like.
Right.
That is very nice.
Alright, let's try this shit again.
And hopefully everyone else is noticing there's a nice little bit of change to the page or some nice little graphics at the bottom instead of the calendar. Yeah.
Oh, there is.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
I figure those are easier to advertise than like put a fucking calendar up.
I really appreciate the shit that we're watching this one.
Oh yeah.
I don't know what it says about me. I thought when I first saw the third one, the Orton pose, I thought that was Quicksilver from PWG.
Oh
yes.
God!
It's stabbing scissors.
I will always associate him with Wrestling Society X when he sneezes.
El Blanco, something, whatever, right?
El Hombre Blanco and Mascarado, the white guy in the mask.
God, Quicksilver was great.
Quicksilver is fucking the shits. Not the shits, the shit.
I was about to say, hey, wait a minute.
Yeah, wait a second. Hold on. Only one shit. He's allowed to be one.
Okay.
He's allowed to be the positive shit.
Okay. I don't know what the fuck's going on here. It just froze on me again, and I went for the ladder match.
Oh, boy.
We are going to have a traditional one-on-one match.
We are going to have a one-on-one match between Ahmed Johnson and Al Snow.
No.
We're going through the roster alphabetically.
He will fight the roster alphabetically.
Oh, my God. Oh, yeah, while we're waiting, Kumite tomorrow. But you knew that because you scrolled down and saw the graphic.
You saw it, guys.
So, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, right, the sensor is not having fun here.
Oh, no.
Dang it, Steven. Why can't we have fun anymore?
You know, if you really wanted to have fun with the right to censor thing, you could bring up that, like, that big no symbol and just have that, like, do, like, the shoot week thing like I do. Mm-hmm. Just have it, like, flash on the screen.
God.
As, like, whenever it's fucking up.
Alright. I'm also going to clean the disc off. It's, pretty clean, but can't hurt.
Oh, is that what happened?
No, I'll just check it. Why not? Yeah, it's not scratched up or
never
anything.
Never hurts to be prepared.
Okay. Take it off the bloody air. The mode part, a font, or custom. It's a font I got.
Yeah.
But I had to edit the shit out of it, though. Rabbit, are you talking about
me?
The WCW one or this one?
Mm-hmm.
Meanwhile, while we're waiting for the stream to come back up.
Oh, God, this again. I'm trying to get better about trying to, like, I'm trying to figure out a good way to, like, remind people that Kumite is coming up. Like, HCL has those, the preview things. I want to do something different from Kumite, but I haven't figured out what yet. I don't know. Because as much as I like doing those hype videos, they're work.
Understandable.
Gone and made a big cheesecake.
I blacked out and puked on my sweater. Which, considering his some of his runs in wrestling, that seems accurate for Eric Bischoff.
No, this is Undertaker's music. But they sound exactly the same, so I don't blame you.
Oh, okay, whatever.
Okay, I think this fucking, like, spot in this, like, show is fucked. So I'm just gonna skip it, and we'll move on to the fucking,
We're going to hardcore heat.
It's one of those things where it's like, the game is trying to make the most insane thing happen.
I can't handle it.
Yeah, it can't handle it.
So we're just gonna skip it. Ahmed Johnson, Al Snow will be the main event, but I'm not watching that because fuck Al Snow. So.
Yeah.
I feel like that's gonna be your ongoing thing. Anytime Al Snow's in a match, we're skipping it.
Yeah.
Regardless of what we had planned.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know why I have him if I'm just gonna, like, fucking.
No, you gotta keep the joke alive. Okay. You gotta keep him out for the joke.
That's fair.
He's gonna wind up becoming your roadblock.
Oh my god, no.
Yeah. You've gotta stop it before it gets stronger.
And then the super fun shit will start in a minute with the hardcore heat.
Yep. Recreate the one episode of Raw where all the ECW guys showed up once. It's Sabu nearly kills himself jumping off a giant arm.
So funny. He fucked that up so bad.
Who did he actually jump on? Who was he supposed to jump onto?
What was it? It was Team Taz.
And he just ate it, or he slipped? No, he slipped, didn't he?
No, the fucking R wobbled.
Sure. Yeah.
Or the A, or whatever the fuck.
Yeah. A for asshole.
Look at Sabu!
A for Sabu! A for Sabu.
A for Sabu.
You will watch Ahmed and Al Snow, and you will like it, damn it. So, current hardcore champion is Hardcore Holly. So.
Okay.
For the record, that's probably going to be the most that that'll ever make sense. Going downhill from here.
Alright, at least Ahmed Johnson won.
Okay, good.
Alright, we're gonna skip all these matches here. Sky Duhati beat Raven. Bart Gunn beat Albert. X-Pac beat Viscera. And Moppy beat Haku.
What?
I'm not even surprised this time.
And Haku dropped to a mop.
Okay, I'm just gonna exit. This has been a fun stream. I'm kidding. So. Alright, it's time for Hardcore Heat.
Hardcore Heat.
What the? It was like you were held hostage and told to sing it.
Hardcore Heat!
Well, Hardcore Thunder has too many syllables.
That has the right amount. That Heat does not.
Exactly.
Cheap imitation.
Alright, let's see who the first opponent for Hardcore Holly tonight is going to be. In the ring, he will take on... it's loading here. Here we go. His first opponent will be tonight, not Jinder Mahal. Not Edge. Steve Blackman, shit, alright.
Oh, God.
Okay, so we're sticking with the hardcore division, never mind.
All right. No, it's going with anybody.
No, I know, that's what I'm saying, but like, it's actually making sense.
Yeah.
Oh, so you can't have it like just randomized from only the...
Nah. Here we fucking go.
Tonight at Hardcore Mania 13.
It's like that time in the Royal Rumble where it became like a hardcore Royal Rumble.
And it kind of sucked.
And now came Kane and just beat the shit out of everybody.
As he does.
I think it was Kane, right?
That, it that, was. That it was 2001, so yeah. Oh my god, they look like they're Siamese twins.
Oh no. They're joined at the bicep.
Here comes the Bobcore. Representing the Hugger Oranges car. Alright, this is literally the same entrance fucking Bossman had, so.
Listen, here you little shithead.
Ain't afraid of you, Big Show.
That'd be great if like you took his like actual theme and like put those quotes in over it instead.
I ain't afraid of you, Big Show.
Stupid shitty.
Down at the down, down. Okay.
I'm throwing plug. Everybody calls it Sparky.
How do you like me now?
How do you...
His name was Thurman Plug at some point.
Yes, it was.
Like, let's be honest. If your last name's Plug, people didn't call you Sparky as a nickname. They had a worse nickname.
There were signs in the crowd that said Butt Plug on them.
Plug, your friends didn't call you Butt Plug. You had very uncreative friends.
Yeah, Bob Holly got that title match, so they wouldn't sue. So he wouldn't sue because of the whole Brock Lesnar snapping his neck like a fucking biscuit deal. I'm talking about one of the fancy British biscuits, not one of ours here that Bob Corr probably would eat.
I was actually going to make note of that.
Or a cracker. I need a cracker.
Oh, no.
It looks good for Blackman, though, because he did beat D'Lo and Dan Severn on Raw. Only makes sense that he'd do it here. It's a Bob Corr.
Did he win already?
Yeah, Blackman was on Raw. He beat,
No, I meant that he won this match already. I was like,
oh, no, no.
Beating Parker, like, already? I'm like, fuck, man.
First thing I hear when loading the stream is it stuttering and saying Sue, 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 Sue.
Yeah.
That's fucking fun. Yeah. I mean, Bob Holly might be an apprehensible person, but at least he's a good wrestler, I guess, you know?
Yeah, at least he was good at something.
I mean, sometimes you can overpass it and overlook it, unlike, like, Dynamite Kid or Chris Benoit.
Yeah.
Or Dynam or up that
I was trying to think of like one really random one to throw in there. I was Jesus. Like, or like I was gonna go with Mabel. I was like, wait, he's dead.
Savio Vega.
Or Savio.
You know what you fucking did. Miguel Perez Jr., you know what you did with your fucking furry back.
He wrestled in fucking Puerto Rico. He probably did something fucking terrible.
That's fair.
Like, the odds are not in his favor for that one.
Bobcore just getting weapon after weapon out of the fucking ring. Oh, Jesus! I'm getting a replay of that going here. Time for the Stridex instant replay here. Oh, right onto the garbage can, crushing it.
The face on Blackman as he goes to the garbage can is great.
The Steve Blackman pull-up doll, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh fuck! Oh my God! Is he biting his arm?
It looks like it, kinda.
Oh my God!
Sorry, it's that time of the night, guys.
Just two dudes falling on a trash can.
How do you like me now?
Oh my God. If I did this with WCW Universe mode, we'd never get through a single show in a night.
Aw, that's cute. What do you think of this, referee? I'm not even looking at it. He doesn't care. He's so disgusted by it.
Entirely done with everything to do with this.
It looks like he should be joining Air Supply with that face.
Yeah, just Photoshop him over the two Air Supply dudes.
Fuck.
There you go. Okay, back to the match. My plan is
like,
to get it.
Like, he should be more engaged. Like, if someone just got back suplexed onto a garbage can outside the ring, I feel like the referee should be a little bit more engaged in that.
Yeah, he does a stupid thing. It's Blackman go. He's going for a sledgehammer. Peter Gabriel up in this bitch. Oh, right in the stomach. And he's killing Bob Holly with that sledgehammer right now.
Oh, God. I heard him screaming, "This is for Capitelli."
Oh, Jesus. We'll know what that means in a few years.
I'm hanging on to my theory that Holly is who gave in. Bob Holly stiffing that Capitelli on Tough Enough is what gave him cancer.
Had to have been. Is that what people say legit, though?
Do they really?
I think so, yeah.
I thought I was just a terrible person.
No, I think just people actually think that.
Oh, Christ.
Oh my God! Suplex onto the fucking end of the sledgehammer. That's gotta be it. Ah, two count! Jesus! Alright.
There's a lot of suplexes of people onto things.
Oh, we getting another suplex here? No, a shitty Falcon Arrow.
Did the deal.
Oh, Alabama Slam onto the fucking... Oh my God! Fuck!
Is Blackman dead?
Yeah, Blackman's kind of dead. Oh no, he had a seizure.
Fuck. Oh, Jesus. His head just misses it.
You Guess what? From this angle, it doesn't. No, no, it hit him. It hit him.
Really? Fuck.
That has to be
Steve
it.
Black. Oh my god. Oh my god, Steve Blackman is dead.
No, he is not. He kicked out. What the fuck? What the fuck, Steve Blackman? And we got a new hardcore champion.
Just sold, no sold leg with nothing.
What the fuck?
Well, this game.
And there we go, new hardcore champion, Steve Blackman. Alright, next match is also for the hardcore title, because it is Hardcore Heat.
Sounds oddly familiar.
Don't know what you're talking about. Oh, we got a, Steve Blackman has won the Hardcore Championship. That's gonna blare like fucking 9 times during this. Alright. Back to the show. Edit. Customize freely. Tunnel match. Okay, this one should be backstage brawl and a triple threat.
Wait a second. Why is it a triple threat?
God damn it, I get to choose and pick. That's what I did last time. Alright, this time, backstage, the opponents will be... Crash Holly.
Still hitting the random button?
Yep. Okay. And...
Undertaker Retro.
D'Lo Brown. So, let's do this up here.
I feel like if it's Undertaker Retro, he should be, like, in, like, bell bottoms.
Yeah, that'd be nice. Like, like 70s gear.
He's staying alive, Undertaker.
Staying alive.
Exactly that.
Alright, let's see how Steve Blackman fares backstage here.
Is backstage, like, is it knockout only, or is it pinfalls? What's the...
It's, knockout. It can be knockout or pinfall, but it's, like, it's individual, so it's a dance, too.
Nah.
There you go. Blake, did you miss it?
Oh, no.
Steve Blackman got Alabama slammed onto a fucking, he got Alabama slammed onto a sledgehammer, no-sold it, kicked Hardcore Holly in the fucking face and pinned him for the belt. Now we're backstage, and a very pissed off D'Lo Brown, upset about getting pinned first in that triple threat match, is going at it with
Basically what happened is Steve Blackman left with the title. He was accosted backstage by two men.
By two Marines. Super kick party.
Yes. Super kick.
Oh, we got a cold drinks brand, cold drinks vending machine here. That's back. Oh, deal being shucked.
That's a nice sponsor. But it's no plates.
Plates? Fuck off. Oh!
Plates.
What the fuck is this? What are you doing, Steve Black? Oh, Jesus. That's concrete. That's unforgiving concrete. There's no pads here, Kang. Oh, Jesus.
And I bet there's some kid at home saying, oh, they know how to fall.
They train. They're trained to fall. Oh, pin. I don't know if he's out or not. I don't think so. I think it's knockout only. See, Blackman just kind of letting them take each other on right now. Oh, he gets chucked right into him, though. I still can't believe fucking Steve Blackman survived that shit. That's fucked up.
He's like the Terminator.
Seriously.
It's terrifying.
Oh, the stroke onto the floor. Just something that Steve Blackman looked like he had after that fucking incident with the sledgehammer.
Jesus.
Oh, God, no! Oh, fuck that. Oh, jeez, okay.
What?
Styles Clash onto the floor to D'Lo.
Who has the Styles Clash?
Crash.
Why?
He used to have that.
It's the Styles Crash?
Yeah. Oh! And D'Lo's out. Oh, fuck! What? What the fuck was that? I think that cart won the hardcore title for a second. Jesus.
That cart might be the champion.
I think the cart is temporary champion.
What in the holy hell?
What the fuck was that? There's fucking, like, phones and shit everywhere now. Steve Blackman is also a wizard. Yeah, no kidding after that shit. Oh my god! No, nothing. Oh, Jesus! And Blackman retains. No shock after that move. Oh, fuck you, Rabbit Raccoon. That was not cart gun.
Steve Blackman wins by being the most sadistic piece of shit out. Just actively injuring the fuck out of people.
Seriously, what the fuck? Cart gun.
Are now he's giving him the business.
Cart gun. Are you fucking kidding me?
Speed bump Mike Bailey, yes.
Yeah, seriously.
Who needs a speed bump when you have a concrete obstruction?
Alright, specialty title match. Guess what? It's another fucking hardcore title match. I know, right?
I don't like hardcore title matches, but guess what? You're gonna like it.
Alright, I have a feeling this one should be a fatal four-way. Oh, it's gonna be a fucking.
This all sounds oddly familiar. All
right, it'll be a fucking. No, fuck you. It'll be a fatal four.
This sounds oddly familiar.
All right, Blackman, he's in. Who else is gonna be in this? Not Hogan. Draws. He might be a double champion here. Steven Regal, the real man's man. And Viscera. What a lineup. You didn't. It will not be win, lose, or draws. God damn it. That's just awful. All right. Yeah, it's after midnight. I think this will be the last match for tonight, and then we'll pick it up afterwards.
I'm about to call it quits because I've already fallen asleep on the couch. No offense, I'm just fucking exhausted.
It's fine. This will be it.
I'd very much like it if all y'all that are still here would, come check out the Kumite tomorrow. Kumite. Starts at 8 p.m. Eastern. We go live. 10 fights, including the quarterfinals of the 93-kilo tournament. Barbara, Miami-Dade County, Eric Helheim, Masa Ahondara, Horst Duvers, Sergey Matryoshka, Father Chad, and Goran Hunsalar, I had to think who the last name was. You see the fucking thing down at the bottom? There's a nice little graphic there. You should be at that thing. It's here. It's in Japan, but it's here. You can watch it. You don't have to be anywhere other than just at your computer. It's like a trip to Japan for your computer.
Kinda.
Hey, fuck you, you're getting tired, Brian, after midnight. Alright, so who did you determine who's facing who in this heart? So, Blackman found it was not safe to go backstage. He decided to stay out here in the... He decided to stay out by the ring, and he's got three more challenges, right?
Yes.
Is that what's happening?
Correct, Amundo.
Who are his opponents? I missed it.
Well, let's just have be a surprise for you then.
My hair down. Yes, my fucking. I don't give a shit. I am fucking tired.
Brian normally keeps it in a nice. He keeps it in a nice man bun normally, so it's kind of weird to see it like
this.
Oh
no! You know what? I'm sorry. Fuck the man bun. No. Nope. 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 Fucking man buns.
Now, here's the interesting thing. Draws is IC champion, so we might have a double champion here.
If I was more awake, I'd try to come up with something that IC stood for that made fun of his paralysis.
Intentionally crippled?
Sure.
There you go. Alright, let's skip these entrances here. Not skip them, but... We'll give them the WrestleMania 2... we'll give them the No Mercy entrance just down the ramp. Brian fucks man buns. Comment.
Sure, why the fuck not?
Speaking of fucking man buns, a real man's buns that might be fucked here. Steven Regal.
Real man's man bun. God damn it.
To quote Rich Voss, he's a man man. Which is something he actually did say, and he was trying to say man's man. He's a man man. Icy belt is not on the line.
This is our goal, to give Blackman all the titles.
Yep. You got us.
It's an now, idea I just put up.
Now, I said I was going to skip the entrances, but his music's too fucking good. There we go. Yeah, Regal is in both universes, isn't he?
Such a man.
Haku is in... Well, Haku and Ming. They kind of look similar, so... I don't know what the deal is there, but... And finally, we got Big Viz. Big ol' Viscera.
A big ol' Viz.
Big pleather Viscera here.
Pleather Viz. Leather and leather.
All right. Get this started here. It's gonna take him 80 years to get to the ring, so I'm just skipping it. He could have lived and died in the amount of time it would take for him to get to the ring.
He lives, he dies, he lives again.
Oh no.
The world's largest.
Do not make me paint Viscera silver.
The world's largest fuck machine.
Here we go.
So you know how like the whole Hogan versus Flair naming convention is basically like what someone who doesn't watch wrestling would call somebody? Like, oh, that's that H3 guy. You mean Triple H? Yeah, him. I feel like someone would hear the name Draws, and if you said it the right way or the wrong or the proper way or a certain way, people would think that you were referring to like the slang for underwear, like, oh, your drawers.
Yeah.
I'm just being like Draws.
He constantly shits his, so.
Sure. Why not? Or he's Dr. Oz, yeah.
Dr. Oz, oh god. Yeah.
Yeah, we've been making that joke for a while.
That's fucking great. Or at least great.
I've seen it somewhere else. I feel like Blake's done that with his...
Has he?
I thought he did. I could be completely making that up, but...
It's fine.
No, I can't.
A lot of brawling on the outside, a lot of garbage cans, a lot of ladders.
They are really brawling for it all.
Barty Gunn is not in this match. Oh my god! Oh my god!
Uh-oh. Who should I be watching?
I'm replaying it.
Okay. Because, like, I'm just seeing people brawl. Oh, Jesus! Okay, there it is. Well, shit. Well, he's dead now.
Oh, jeez, fuck.
Well, he's dead now.
Moment of silence for Steve Regal, please.
He's got a hip toss. Just a fucking hip toss.
Referee, what the fuck are you doing? Wow! The referee's a fucking ninja.
He is stairs now.
That's impressive by Charles Robinson, though.
That's pretty good. It's a fucking game.
You okay, buddy?
How is Regal through the stairs? That's not good.
They fucking... What is it called when the TARDIS fucking, like, disappears and reappears?
That's basically it.
No, there was a word for it.
Like it materialized?
It dematerialized right there. Okay, if he's not dead after that, I'm fucking stunned. And Viz were capitalizing it by walking in place. Oh, fuck. Okay.
There's more.
Just murdering Steve Regal here.
Murder killing.
Alright, I guess we'll wrap up next week. Oh, we'll wrap up this Hardcore Heat next week, and then we'll move on to the next episode of Raw and SmackDown. And then do another Hardcore Heat, because NXT was on tonight.
What happened to this match? Like, did you quit this
match? No, it's still going. I'm just plugging.
Okay.
Give me the old plug-ola here.
Yes.
And Regal just got hit right in the fucking head with a baseball bat. Oh, Steve Blackman has been utilizing sledgehammers recently, I've noticed. He's still using them here.
That sounds like something you'd hear as like a tip on like a hotline. Steve Blackman has been using these sledgehammers lately. I wonder if blah, 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 blah. And then Kevin Kelly talks about hot singles in your area because you've got to read the.
There are hot singles in your area. What? All right, Steve Blackman, I believe, eliminated draws there, so it's down to three.
All right.
Oh shit! And Steve Regal's it. Uh oh. Viscera catches Steve Blackman though.
Regal winning this whole thing would be fucking incredible after that.
Yeah, seriously. Up, Regal on the pin. Up, Steve Blackman kicks out somehow. Well, what do you mean somehow? He's Steve Blackman. We all know why.
This is going to eventually get old and it's going to like LOL Blackman wins, huh?
Yeah, seriously. Blackman roadblock. Oh, Viscera. Oh, the dream's over. Steve Blackman's been eliminated. Alright, Viscera here. Viscera and Regal. Up, pin. Up, Regal kicks out.
We're down to Regal and Viscera?
Yes.
Dang.
Oh, Jesus. Former King of the Ring, Viscera, let me remind you. Oh, two former King of the Rings, actually. Mabel.
Oh, it was in, like, in real life. I didn't mean, like, in this game. I was like, what the fuck happened in this game?
Jesus, Regal. Stop, stop. He's already dead. Like, fuck.
He's going to win this thing, man.
I hope. I couldn't. I can't have Viscera as a champion here.
Sure you could.
I could, but I wouldn't like it. Hi, Rake. Oh, Jesus. Oh, good. Okay, I was worried he was going to throw him on the ladder.
You worry too much.
Oh, that was close. That was close. I think that's it.
Oh.
Yeah, and Viscera is our hardcore champion.
Congratulations,
Gristle.
Oh, he just missed the ladder.
Oh, that's so close. Fuck.
One person in the booing.
Boo.
Good on you, sir. Good on you, what hath science done?
Much like Vince Russo booking, great beginnings and middle, anticlimactic ending.
And that's the fucking story of my streams. Welcome to streaming regularly.
And there's Viscera of the hardcore title. He's too fat to probably wear it.
That's probably fair.
Okay, on that somber note, we're gonna go to sleep now. yeah. Kumite tomorrow. This.
I'm gonna pass the fuck out.
Yeah, this next week. After the day after WCW. So, yeah.
I think that's kind of been the thing, is like. You're basically just gonna follow the day after I stream with WCW.
Yeah. And there is Viscera Face. If you want to screen cap that, go right ahead.
Yep, I do. I sure do. That is a thing.
Yeah, so Kumite tomorrow, the shit next week, the Sunday.
I definitely do want some of these screen caps because they'll be needed for when I make the custom thumbnails for YouTube.
Oh jeez, yeah.
I'm working on them for I'm working on them right now.
That's fair, yeah.
So having some of these would help.
Yes. All right.
Stare at that horror. Stare at the horror.
Stare into the abyss of his mouth.
Viscera. Viscera is part rabbit in that picture.
This is the music's playing in the background. Okay. Shop for watching a Sunday. Kumite tomorrow. Maybe a stream. Maybe a secret surprise stream during the weekend at a random hour. Random ungodly hour. So, yeah.
Not for me. I ain't gonna be around.
It's probably gonna be me.
I know.
Jesus. So, for Blake, Brian, and me, spay and neuter your pets. Good night.
Good night. Cut your pet's genitals off.
Cut your dog's balls off and rip your dog's vagina out for health, for their health.